We have looked at the morphology of the seafloor from the coast to the abyssal plain and to the processes moving water masses. We're now ready to look at how these interact with the sediments which are being transported by the rivers to the sea. In this clip, we will provide some initial answers to questions such as, how are these sediments reworked? Where will they end up? Do their properties change during this stage? What will be the special architecture? We will begin looking at coasts away from deltas and/or estuaries, and which are dominated by the action of tides. This means that waves are of subordinate importance. Tides cause changes of sea level and thereby a gradual transgression and regression of the water covering the intertidal domains. The width of the area covered and uncovered during tides is a function of the height of the tide and the steepness of the coast. In cases such as the famous one you see in the picture, it can be of several tens of kilometers. In a map view, we can see the phenomena associated with the rise and fall of sea level driven by tides. By rising sea level, the water mass will gradually move towards the coast, passing through tidal inlets and eventually invading the entire intertidal zone. This process is generally gradual and relatively slow, with only limited sediment transport or reworking. When peak tide passes and sea level decreases, waters will retreat towards the sea. They will do this not in the same homogeneous way they did while rising, but rather getting concentrated in narrow flow paths. Because of the narrow paths, velocity will increase and tides become erosive, forming a network of channels and bringing sediments back to the sea. This is then what the tide-dominated coast looks like. The wide intertidal zone is characterized by marshes and standing waters, typically with fine-grained sediments and very active biologic communities. The tidal channels are a distinctive feature of the tidal systems and accommodate the movement of waters and sediments to the sea and backwards. Tidal barriers and inlets form the last important features typical of tide-dominated coasts. Coasts in which waves are much stronger than tides look very different. We have seen how waves break when the seafloor shallows to less than half of the wavelength of the incoming wave. The breaking of a wave is a very high energy process, which mobilizes large amounts of sediments, which are then transported and dumped in linear features along the coast as the water slows down, coming then to a still stand. In map view, you can see the waves breaking and depositing sands in sandbanks and slowing down reaching the coast. Having hit the coast, the water set in movement by waves will return back to the sea, focusing channelized flow along called rip currents. These are strong currents able to bring sediment back to the sea. The entire process starts again with the seafloor being constantly remobilized by breaking currents. This is what simplified wave-dominated looks like. Elongated ridges and barriers often also submerged. Behind these regions, a more protected domain with bodies of sand transported by the breaking waves. Winds and waves do not always move perpendicular to the coast and are often oblique to it. In this case, waves hitting the coast are deflected, giving rise to a component of movement parallel to the coast itself. These are called alongshore currents, which can erode, transport, or deposit sand along the coast. Walking along the coast, you see typical effects of alongshore currents, such as coastal groynes and spits. In steep coasts, the wave hit with her full power the cliffs with a strong erosive energy. As a result, the foot of the cliff is eroded, causing the collapse of the overlying rocks and the retreat of the cliff face. An abrasion surface is created. Steep coasts are very different from flat and shallow coasts. The coastal domains areas are regions of great scientific and technical interest, are areas of great importance, economic importance too. We are now ready to make the next step of our journey. In the next clip, we will enter the wide continental shelves.